Hey Tackle Warehouse fans, welcome to another how-to video where I, Laura Ann, will be showing you how to tie a double uni knot. Anglers have been using this technique from freshwater to saltwater for a very long time. This is a very easy and efficient way to combine monofilament or fluorocarbon to braid. Okay guys, so for demonstration purposes, we're going to be using 150-pound braid in the colors yellow and white. Our white is going to represent our mono or fluorocarbon, and our yellow is going to represent our braid. So let's go ahead and lay this out on the table. I recommend if you're doing this for the first time to find a flat surface to do this on so that you can really visually see what you're doing. That's going to really help you get started. Let's go ahead and find the center of where our lines meet, and let's make a pinch and pull out to the braided side. So we're going to go ahead and start with our braided tag. We're going to lift that and loop it back just like this. So it makes almost a little U shape right here, and then you have your overlapping line right here. So for this part, we're gonna go ahead and start making some wraps around these two, around the braid and the fluorocarbon or monofilament. And for braid, you're gonna want to do the most wraps on this side. It's totally preference as to how many wraps you wanna make. But typically I'll do like six on the right side, and then we'll do half of that for the mono or fluorocarbon on the other side. So we're gonna start off with six wraps right here. So we're gonna go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, and then when you're finished with that, you're gonna slowly and softly pull that together, going very slowly and carefully, making sure that you're not burning or damaging any of your line. And then you're going to cinch this line right here, but you're not going to cinch it all the way. Just leave it a little bit loose, and I'll show you why later. So let's go ahead and go over to the fluorocarbon side. So starting back at the middle, you're gonna pinch and pull out. Take that fluorocarbon line, tuck it inwards and back towards you, make that U shape. Still have your mono or fluorocarbon lined up with your braid. And we're gonna go ahead and we're gonna do three this time on this side. So 1, 2, 3. And then go ahead and slowly, softly pull that back together. All right, and then now all we have to do is marry the two. So we're gonna take the main line on both sides and pull them in towards each other. And this is when we're really gonna cinch our knot as tight as we can. And I would go ahead and do a couple of test tugs on it, make sure that everything's working right and there weren't any errors. And now all we have left to do is cut the tags off. So when you're cutting the tags off, you just wanna make sure that you're leaving a little bit left over in case the knot slips. And then just to elaborate on why we ended up using six wraps for the braid and three for the fluorocarbon, the reason we did that is because braid has a much slicker surface and is more likely to slip. So giving it a couple more wraps just gives it that extra security that you need, while the fluorocarbon has a lot more grip to it, so you don't have to worry about having as many wraps. Usually you'll use about half as much wraps for the fluorocarbon. Now let's go ahead and check out this quick clip from Sunline that they gave us to give us a little bit of a different visual on how that knot is tied. So guys, if you learned something from this video, go ahead and give it a like. And then if you have any questions or comments or suggestions on what we should make in the future, go ahead and comment that below. You can find more videos like this at the Learning Center at tacklewarehouse.com. Tight lines, and we'll see you on the water.